So a question I get a lot is, how do I come up with different phrases to use on my t-shirts? Well, with the internet, there's so many different ways to come up with phrases. I'm going to show you all those different ways, as well as a new tool that Vexels has made with AI that will help you easily help you get some phrases that you can use for any topic on your t-shirts. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I wanted to share with you the different ways that you can come up with phrases for your t-shirts. And then in the end of this video, I'm gonna show you the tool from Vexels with AI to help you get those phrases. So first, let's get to the internet and I'll show you all the different ways that you can find phrases for your t-shirts. All right, so the first and very basic way to find t-shirt ideas or t-shirt phrases is to just come in here to Google. So let's say you want a funny cat t-shirt. And just to here, and I like to go to images, but you can do whatever. And then you can see, like, here's one, coffee because murder's wrong with a cat, or women and cats. But we don't know, first of all, if these are trademarked, and we don't know if these are very popular sellers. We can assume that they are popular because they come up in Google search, but we don't know what platform or whatever this is. So the next step, the better way, would be to come into Amazon and you can start typing in cat t-shirts or funny cat t-shirts, right? If you sell on Amazon, you would do this. If you sold on Redbubble, you'd do their search. Funny cat t-shirt. And you can see these are the most popular, but again, you'd still have to check, and all of these you would have to check USPTO. But you don't wanna copy exactly what everybody else is doing, because if you did this, Let's say, look, Meowty is popular. Let's do Meowty t-shirts. You see, everybody's doing Meowty. In fact, these two are almost exactly the same, which can give you some copyright issues, trademark issues as well. And so you see there's a bunch of them that are copying Meowty here. And so it's gonna just get super saturated with Meowty and you're gonna be on page 5 and so on. Same thing with Redbubble. If you came in here and you did funny cat t-shirt, you know, you could copy any one of these, but then again, it's gonna get saturated. You're gonna be copying its trademark and all that stuff. So again, you can get an idea of what people are selling on Redbubble or on Amazon. You can do this as well with something like Pretty Merch Pro, where if you did funny cat t-shirt again here, I'm in the research tab. Oh, it's already at t-shirts, but you can see here's some other ideas. There's Meowty again and what. So I would use this as a base of what kinds of things sell, but don't copy the phrase here, because those phrases could potentially be trademarked as well as could be super saturated, right? Here are some other ideas using AI. So I showed this before. This is Canva and I got the magic right here. I showed you how to use that, but let me just show you how you can use AI to come up with ideas. So I'm just gonna type in, give me 5 ideas for simple phrases for a funny cat t-shirt, right? And there you go. So here's some funny phrases that AI came up with. And of course, you still have to run this through USPTO and make sure they're not trademarked. But these have a better shot of you getting into the niche and not being saturated, right? When everybody is looking for Meowty, you have a different phrase here that's your own. The AI came up with, hopefully somebody else is not using this. I would do research again to see if this is something that a lot of people are using, but you can see really quick, and I could have done 10 ideas, I could have done whatever phrase right here, right? So AI is now giving me examples, and then you could base it off of this too, right? So get some words here, maybe some phrases and rhyming words, and brainstorm that way. So now that you've seen all these ways, let me show you what Vexels has done to like simplify this. They took all this kind of information by including the AI and try to make it even more simple for us to use and get phrases. So if you log into Vexels, you'll see something similar to this. I'm here on quotes.vexels.com. You can also go to that site. But here, let me show you what happens when you hit start for free. Look at this. They've made it very intuitive. So of course there's cats here. There's a bunch of topics you can see right here. Lots of different topics. So these are the popular niches, but of course you can put your own niche here or niche. But let's do cats. I'll show you how this works. And then there's different types. So we typed funny cats, right? So I can do funny cats. And then also it'll tell you the length. So if you want something longer or shorter, let me say I want something short, maybe just a short 2-3 word phrase. It's gonna try it again. So you can see feeling fine, catitude overload, and so on. So you can do a lot of these, again, rhyming words right here. Really cool. So these two things is, I can ask for more like this, or I could copy this. So let me show you how it works. So meow is wow, more like this. It's just gonna run AI again and give you spit out more that are like that. So it's really cool. If you didn't like that one, but you kinda like it, you can use that. Look at that, short ones again. So tons of ideas now, right? And you got way more than 10, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Catchy. 9, 10, yeah, so 10. It gives you 10, but you can also try again and give you more and more. So let's try a different, so let's say we want a different mood. So maybe we don't want funny, maybe we want sarcastic, which is kind of funny, but in a different way, right? It does that. Or you could do motivational. So depending on what your cat graphic looks like, you can change the mood on it, and look at that. Pretty cool, right? Just that easy. And again, you have to take this, stay positive, or whatever it is, positively awesome, and then go check that on USPTO. Now I'm gonna try a different one, so let's try again, or let's get out of here and do a different animal or different thing. So I could do astrology, I could do beer, I could do any one of these, but you're not limited to this. So one thing that I did for my 30 days of design is I did abstract art. Check this out. Now I had no idea what to use for that, but this can help me get some ideas of what to use for abstract art, right? And maybe I want it funny. Whoops, it was already giving me ideas. Look at that. Art is weird. And this is how I got that phrase that I used on mine. I just hit it a couple times and found the one that I want. And you can do that. Pretty cool, right? So you may be wondering, well, this is great, but do I just do just for these? You can. You can start here. There's a bunch of them that you can start with. But you may be wondering, like, what topics should I use? When should I use it? I mean, a lot of these are evergreen. But if you go to my site, to the downloads page, you can see this one right here, the holiday t-shirt niches, as well as my calendar, this one right here. They both have the same thing. This one just lays it out in a nice calendar form. The other one is just the text. So this will tell you what to work on. So these are the topics. It can work perfectly with these. Let's see. So I'm gonna say, we're in May right now, so go 2 months ahead, June, July. So you should be working on these. Type in these right here, Independence Day, Bride and Groom, Barbecue, Beaches, Family Reunions, into that in Vexels, and it will spit you up a bunch of phrases. Make sure to check USPTO that they're not trademarked, but then now you can design with that. And Vexels already has graphics there, so it's a win-win. So if you're on Vexels already, you can go look for, you know, something that works with barbecue. So I'll show you what I mean. So let's do that. So let's do barbecue. Maybe funny, right? We'll have it work here. Okay, so let's do barbecue boss right there. It just gives you so many. You could do all of these, which is crazy because you could scale this, right? So you have one picture, put all of these, why not? Barbecue boss, all right. So I'm gonna save that and then I'm gonna go back to Vexels And then let's look barbecue. Of course, you could draw your own barbecue stuff, but now you could take one of these barbecue stuff and type in barbecue boss instead of grill sergeant, barbecue boss here, right? All works together. Like you could use any one of these. You could say barbecue boss right here. Pretty easy. So that's how you use it. And then go back and try one of those other topics and phrases and then just scale this thing. It's amazing. So that's how easy it is to get ideas and phrases for t-shirts, and works really well here in Vexels, or you know, any clip art that you already have. Maybe you are drawing like me and drawing kawaii stuff, and then you can use those topics. So another thing you could do is, if you haven't done my 30 days of design, my Shirttober in April, I'll put those as well in my download, so you can also have those topics. So another good place to find good topics, and I shared this before, and this is where I got all my topics for Shirttober in April, is TeePublic. So go down here and go to tags, and here are all the topics that are popular for TeePublic. So if you're selling on TeePublic, look in here, and like maybe you want to do a hockey t-shirt, run hockey through the Vexels thing, or maybe you want to do a horse right here, or you know, stay away from copyright stuff. So don't do Bluey, don't do Goku, don't do Sandlot, but you can do jazz or cottagecore, you know, as a style. That would be a really cool one. So have fun with this. Hopefully this was really helpful. This, I know this is a lot on here, but again, try the quote generator with Vexels. I think it's free for everybody to start, so you can test it out and try it out. It's in beta right now, so they're gonna even make it better and better, but you can see it's pretty intuitive. It's using the power of AI, and it's spitting out a ton of phrases that you can use to take one design and scale it and put all these different phrases on there. So have fun with this one, and hopefully you can grow your t-shirt business online. So there you go. Those are all the different ways to find different phrases that you can use on t-shirts. We live in such a great time where AI can help us do all these things. You can get graphics from Vexels, you can get graphics from Canva, you can get graphics from anywhere online, as well as phrases. So all you have to do is like put it together and put it on the t-shirt for free again. And if you're on Redbubble or TeePublic or Amazon, all of those are free. So why not do those if you have the time, and you can put it all together in Vexels or Canva or Affinity Design. Like, we have so many options now, it's crazy. So if you want to learn more about Vexels, you can click on this video right here and learn more about Vexels. It's very powerful. Not only does it have the generator, but it has so many more things. If you're interested in that one, I'll also leave a link to Vexels in the description there. Thanks again for watching, and as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.